Namaste, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making Bhakarwadi. I already shared video of Bhakarwadi earlier and that was a fried version. Today I'm going to show you how we can bake even Bhakarwadi. So this is perfect snack for picnic party, little get together, or even if you're going for a long trip. This is the perfect snack that you will satisfy your crave for some spicy snack. Bhakarwadi is a very popular snack where I grew up, and I really love the spicy Bhakarwadi with my coffee or tea, or you can just eat as it is. For kids, you can make with a mild flavor, but usually it is very spicy, these Bhakarwadis. But you can always adjust the preference of the spiciness as per your family. So let's first make the dough. So here I have this sieve, and first I'm going to add plain flour, maida, and you can see that I have filled a little bit up than the level of the cup. So basically I'm taking more than 1 cup of all-purpose flour and less than 1 cup of besan, chickpea or garbanzo flour. So quickly just shake it so that you can shift this flour easily. And do you see how many lumps it has? So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to break those lumps with the spatula. All right, that is done. Now here I have this pinch of a turmeric powder, haldi, salt. I'm not going to add all of it. I'm going to keep some for stuffing. So you can add as per your taste. Here I have this asafoetida, hing, and combine all these dry ingredients. All right, okay, I forgot to add baking powder, so I'm going to add baking powder. And once I mix all these dry ingredients, here I have this oil, and I will need some water to knead the dough. Now this dough, you have to keep it a little hard, do not make it too soft. So I'm going to add about 1 teaspoon of baking powder. All right, again mix it. Add 3 to 4 tablespoons of oil. Well, you can reduce if you don't like to add too much oil, but I want to make the layer kind of a crispy, nice and crispy. And now water, and I'm going to knead this dough nice and a little hard. So I don't think I will need any more water, so I'm going to keep kneading till I get the smoothness of this dough and no more water. So water, even I just added a less than 1/4 cup of water. But all flour takes different amount of water, so you always have to add little at a time, slowly, so that you know how much you will need to add more. If you think it's too dry, that you won't be able to roll even, you can just sprinkle a little bit of water, not too much, just like that, and then finish with kneading. So here you can see that I have this dough ready. And you can see that it's hard, not too soft. So if you pinch your finger, you cannot easily pinch. So this is how we want, and this is perfect. All right, so this dough is ready, and I'm going to cover it and put it on the side. So allow it to rest for 15-20 minutes. And meanwhile, you can prepare the stuffing. So here I have lined up some ingredients to prepare stuffing. And here I have this blender. Now, if you have everything very fine, you don't need even blender. You can just mix all these ingredients. I always go ahead and blend these ingredients a little bit so that I can get the nice kind of a paste consistency, so that I can easily spread on a Bhakarwadi. So now I'm going to add all these ingredients into this cup and blend. So one by one, coconut, nariyal, known as in India. Here I have poppy seeds. Now many people ask me, what is this poppy seeds? It is known as couscous, not couscous. It is couscous in India, and you can find easily at many Indian grocers. It has very kind of nuttier flavor, and when you add in your recipes, it brings out nice flavor. If you don't have this, you can use sesame seeds, teal. But traditional recipe calls for this poppy seeds, couscous. Poppy seeds, couscous, dhania, cilantro. Here are this ginger and a green chili paste, adrak, and chili, hari mirch. Now this sugar, garam masala and salt. I will add later. First, I'm going to blend all these ingredients very well. And one more thing here I have is the tamarind pulp, imli chutney or imli paste. I always have the chutney ready in my freezer, so I just pulled out today this date and tamarind chutney, but usually it is just tamarind paste used in this recipe, but it doesn't have to be that particular. Whatever you have, just you can use it. This brings a nice tanginess into this bhakarwadi. Okay, now this I won't need until I'm ready to make bhakarwadi, so I'm going to put this on the side. Now while it's almost done, I'm going to add the rest of the ingredients. So that was sugar, salt to taste, garam masala to taste, and the coriander and the cumin powder. So just give it a one more blend, the final blend. And let me show you how it looks like now. So just open it up and see. This is how we want. And just give it a stir again. And if you want, you can take it out of this blender, but I just give it a good mix in it, and then I just use directly from this blender. So you can see that this is how it looks like now. Perfect. So you saw that preparing this dough is pretty quick. Preparing stuffing is even very quick. So here I have dough and stuffing both ready and ready to rock and roll. So before I start making bhakarwadis, I'm going to turn on the oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. You can keep between 300 to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, so it's preheated Fahrenheit. And here I have this rolling pin, so I'm going to take the medium size of ball and I'm going to roll this dough into, not too thin, not too thick, and just press on the edges. So you can seal all the edges. So what I normally do, I just with my fist, I press a couple of times, and then with your between two of your palm, just press the edges. So you will make the crack-free circle. This helps us to seal all the edges this way. So you can see that how it looks like now. And roll. So ready to roll. And if you get some cracks, that's fine, because we kept the dough a little hard, and also when you add more oil, you tend to get more cracks, but don't worry about those cracks. The edges you can remove after you roll. And rolling, even you don't have to have the perfect circle. Here I have this ready. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add, actually, in this tamarind paste, the imli paste, I'm going to add a little bit of cinnamon powder. It is known as taj in India, or dalchini. So I'm going to add into this paste and then spread on to this the chapati that I have rolled. So mix this powder and make sure that you combine very, very well. Okay, so this paste is ready, and I'm going to spread very thin layer of this paste because it is too spicy. You just don't want to add, you don't want to spread too much here. Smells so good, cinnamon. Okay, so that's perfect. And the stuffing that we prepared, and I do not spread on a side, just in the middle. Leave the edges a little bit empty. And here again, do not spread too much. A very thin layer of this stuffing, just to smooth out like that. And then I'm going to tightly roll it. Now, I kind of make a cylinder a shape, but try to make it kind of a flat little bit, not too round. Well, if you wish, you can make the round, but I kind of like to make bhakarwadis a little bit of an oval shape. So now it's time to cut. So just take out the side, and then you can cut the thickness the way you want. Just a little bit more than half inch is perfect for the bite-sized snack. There you can see that all the bhakarwadis. And what you can do is, if the stuffing has come out a little bit, you can just push it in, just like that. Now if you want to fry, you can fry, but as I said earlier today, I am going to bake today this bhakarwadis. So here I have this baking tray and I'm going to arrange all the bhakarwadis onto the baking tray. So you saw that preparing bhakarwadi is fun actually, and it's more fun because I know that I don't have to fry. I can just bake them once I'm ready. So these days I really enjoy now making this bhakarwadis. So here I have all the bhakarwadis ready and ready to go into the oven. So look at this plate, all the bhakarwadis are ready. And bake for about 20 to 25 minutes or until it's done. So you will get kind of the sides a little bit golden brown color, the actually brown color, and the top of the bhakarwadi is kind of a yellowish and should be hard. And if you wish, you can flip in middle after about I should say 15 minutes, and then allow it to bake again another 10-15 minutes or until done. All right, so the wait is over. I've been baking this bhakarwadi is now almost about 40 minutes. I flipped in between. Look at this bhakarwadi. The color looks perfect, just like a store-bought that is available in India. Now, in the beginning, I had the bhakarwadis like this. I arranged them like this, and then I flipped on the other side like this. Then again, I flipped on the side there where we can see the filling. So that's how I kept playing to bake them all side. So look at them, and I'm going to bring down onto this plate here. Look at this bhakarwadis, already looks so beautiful. I can't wait to try. Look at this plate. So with this baked bhakarwadi, no more mess. When you fry, actually the filling comes out in oil and the oil gets spoiled, and frying is not really fun, but baking is fun. So look at them, they exactly look like the fried one. Actually looks better than fried one and tastes great as well. There is no compromise even in taste. When you bake, the layer of this bhakarwadi, the dough that we prepared, gets crunchy. And what I normally do, if I want to make it more crunchy, I bring down my oven to the lowest temperature after like 40 minutes once I'm done with this baking. And if I have more time, I just pop this bhakarwadis into the oven again and bake them at the lowest temperature. Around 170 is my oven temperature. So I again bake them for about, leave them in the oven for about an hour or half an hour, so that you will get the nice crunchiness of this bhakarwadi. But usually bhakarwadi has inside of it, it's a little bit kind of soft, and the outer layer is a little bit crunchy. So you can expect the exact texture of the bhakarwadi, just like the fried one. They are hot right now. I'm just going to give it one bite. Inside of the bhakarwadi is also baked so great. And I'm not sure whether you can hear the crunchiness. Yummy. Perfect with my Indian chai. So with tea or coffee. And here I have masala chai ready. So this was all about baked bhakarwadi for any occasion. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.